After a severe storm, you might find significant debris and trees littering your property. Having a chainsaw to help with cleanup can be extremely useful. However, safely using a chainsaw takes some knowledge, experience, skill, and confidence. If you're not experienced with a chainsaw, check out this video for everything you need to know from maintenance to startup. Today, we're going to talk about safety. We'll also talk about what to do with the tree that's already on the ground and how to handle the tree that's under tension. Survey your property regularly. If you see heavy branches or large trees that appear to be dead, overgrown, leaning against another tree, structure, or power lines, you should call in a professional arborist or tree specialist to remove these. The same holds true after a storm. If you see large trees damaged, bent, or broken, know that the weight and tension caused by trees in this situation is best handled by a professional with the right equipment and experience. Before you begin, thoroughly read and understand your chainsaw's owner's manual before you need it. Get to know the saw's features and what each control does. Safety is vital when operating a chainsaw. Start with the right protective clothing. Protective headwear, safety glasses, and hearing protection are all important. Gloves, long pants, and even special chaps and steel-toed boots are your best options for safety. Chainsaws with a bar length of 20 inches work well for cutting medium to larger trees. Also, a sharp chain is not only better for cutting, it's safer because your cuts are clean and efficient. When cutting, keep the action to the side for the most stability. Reaching above your head can be unstable and unbalanced. Standing directly above a cut is also unsafe. If the chainsaw kicks back while you're hovering over a cut, the saw will be headed directly back at you. Keep your cuts away from the bar tip. Cutting at the bar tip, especially if you are new to using a chainsaw, is likely to result in an unsafe kickback. The safety feature of the chain break is designed to stop the chain when this happens. If it occurs, simply pull back on it to unlock and continue cutting. When a tree is already on the ground, cut it down into manageable sections using two methods, limbing and bucking. Limbing is exactly what it sounds like, removing the limbs from the base. Bucking is cutting the trunk into manageable sections. With the stump, you can either cut it level with the ground or have it professionally removed. To begin limbing, work carefully starting at the base. You can cut downward, called the pulling chain, or cut upward, called the pushing chain. Offsetting cuts keep the chain from binding. Limbs on the underside can be cut if you have a good working height. Limbs under tension can be cut later when the tree can be turned. Large branches can be under great tension and should be cut starting from the outside, working toward the trunk. You might face a few different situations with downed trees, whether you've just cut the tree down yourself or if it came down roots and all because of a storm. If the root ball is exposed and hanging over a hole, know that the roots are extremely heavy and can fall back into the hole with tremendous force if you try to cut the trunk first. When a root ball comes up, it will likely bring lots of soil, rocks, and other debris that you don't want to hit with your chainsaw, so you will need to clean that up first. A pressure washer works great for this. Next, you'll want to limb the roots, cutting them from the ends and moving toward the tree trunk. This will gradually remove the weight. For every section removed, stack it far enough away so that you have a clear working space to continue the job. You may run into a situation where the tree trunk is directly on the ground. You don't want to hit the chainsaw blade on the ground, so make a partial cut through the trunk, then roll the tree over and continue cutting on the opposite side until you're through the trunk. If you need help rolling the tree over, you can use a forestry tool or create a lever using a longboard over a log. Either way, it will give you leverage to move the tree. You may find a tree resting over another tree or debris where one end is elevated. Make the first cut from underneath about 1/3 of the way through, then finish the cut from the top side. If you have a trunk elevated off the ground at both ends, find the point in the middle area where both sides are likely to compress together when cut. Cut 1/3 of the way through from the top and remove the saw. From underneath, offset the saw about an inch from the first cut and cut upwards through the trunk. Now your tree is in manageable pieces and ready for easy disposal. A chainsaw is an effective tool in aiding in post-storm cleanup. Be safe and be prepared. And when it comes time to use it, you'll know how to do it right.